Graph a line with a slope of m equals negative 3 over 2 that goes through the point negative 4, 1. Okay, we have the two things that we need to graph a line. We have a point that it goes through and the slope of the line. So let's first start with putting that point on this Cartesian coordinate plane. We have our origin right here, and this point negative 4, 1 then would be right here. Okay, once you have a point that the line goes through, now we consider the slope. And remember the slope. The slope of a line is going to be the change in y. So some number of units that it changes in the y direction over the change in x. You may have heard this as the rise over run, and that's great. That's a wonderful way to remember it. Just don't get confused that this word rise, that's just kind of making you think of this change in y, because as with this example, we are not rising. We're just changing this this value of y, or this units of y, because this is a negative slope. So it's going to go down from the left to the right. Remember that slope always goes from the left to the right. That's how you read this slope. The line, of course, goes on forever in any in the direction that it is pointed. Okay, rise over the run, change in y. So our slope that we have, our m equals negative 3 over 2. By the way, if you ever have a negative on the fraction, always put it in the numerator for this slope, because we're going from left to right. And because we're going from left to right, this change in x will always be positive, right? We're always going to the right. Okay, so this negative 3, change in y, that means that the change in y is going to be down 3 units. Likewise, the change in x is going to be to the right. It's always going to be to the right as you are considering the slope, to the right 2 units. All right, let's get a bright color here so you can visualize this. From this point that we know is on the line, we're going to go down 3 units. We're also going to go to the right 2 units. So we'll put down our next point, and that's going to be right here. That's another point that's on the line. You can continue this pattern to make it easier to draw your line. So I'm going to go down 3 units from that last point, and I'm going to go to the right 2 units and plot another point. And you really only need 2 points for a line, but just to visualize this, you can do this again, down 3 to the right 2, and on and on and on. It does go to the line does go to the left as well, but we're just drawing the slope first, and now we can kind of work our way backwards, or use a straight edge if you are on paper. And a line is like that. We use the arrows to signify that the line goes on forever.